everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Or if you're new here, my name is Cam, and today I scoured my brush collections and I'm looking for YouTube videos. There is a whole bunch of drugstore starter kits, high-end starter kits, like just makeup starter kits, and I couldn't find a really good like brush starter kit, because when I was looking to like start my collection, which this journey started about 2 years ago, starting my brush collection, it was hard. Like, what type of brushes do I need? What style of brushes? What shape of brushes? Like, they don't have to be... I do want to say right off the bat that you don't have to go out and buy any of these brushes. You can just... You don't have to buy the higher end ones. You just find a brush with a similar shape, a similar, like, style to it, and help you, which I do have 2 to 3 brushes for each type of brush I will be talking about. I think there's 8 or 9 brushes that I think are necessary to do an eye look. Well, not all of them are necessary, but they all serve different purposes and they all help you with different things. So if you only had these 9 brushes, I believe you could get any eye look, anything you so dear desired. So let's just get right into it, and I'm first going to start, like, I'm not going to do it random. I have it set up. The order that I would use the brush is the order that I'm going to talk about my brush, and I always do my eyeshadow first. So I'm going to start with eye brushes, and then I'm going to go to face. So first I would like to talk about how I clean my brushes. All of my brushes were dirty about 3 days ago, and then I sat down at my kitchen sink and I cleaned them all. So the first thing that I do is I take and I put all of my brushes in a bag, in like a BoxyCharm box, a makeup bag, whatever, and then I get a bowl, and in a bowl I put soap. If I've got like a liquid soap, I put my liquid soap, and this is the Clinique Makeup Brush Cleanser, and here's what it looks like. I've used almost all of it, or you could use this Solid Beauty Blender, which I'll talk you through this one first. First, what I do is I take and I pour like 1 tablespoon, 2 tablespoons of this into my bowl, and then I fill it up like maybe halfway full of warm water. And then what I do is I take my brush and I'll dip it in my bowl and I'll mix it around, and then I'll take it out, and then I'll use my little brush pad, which is here. You can make these like getting a Tupperware dish and using super glue. You can buy them at, I believe, the dollar store. Then I take and I just directly swirl it on the brush cleaner. And then I will stick the mat and the brush underneath water with the, like, I don't want to go let the water go in here, so I'm putting my brush down when it's in the water and swirling it and rinse it off. And oftentimes I do that 2 times for every brush, unless the brush is a cream brush. If the brush is meant for cream, like foundation or concealer or cream bronzer, I will end up doing it 3 or 4 times just to make sure I get everything out. This Solid Beauty Blender, what I would do is I would take a warm bowl with just warm water in it, dip the brush in the warm water, swirl it, because in this is the Beauty Blender Solid makeup brush bar. It comes with one too, so you could either dip your brush in the warm water, swirl it in here, and then swirl it on your little mat to clean your brush. And I would do that 2 to 3 times depending on how dirty the brush is. And there you go. You just lay your brushes out to dry, and that is how I clean my brush. The only thing I want to make sure you know is when you clean it, you want to have, so the water is coming down, straight down, you want to have it at like an angle, so that way the water isn't going directly like down the brush. Like, you don't want to stick it directly underneath there. You can ruin your brush that way, and nobody wants to ruin something they spent money on. So that is how I clean my brushes. Now I am going into every eyeshadow brush that I think you need. So the first type of eye brush you need is a, well, you don't necessarily need this one, but I feel like it makes things a whole lot easier. This is my favorite one. This is the Ulta Beauty Large Eyeshadow Brush, and here is what it looks like. It is very flat and just a large brush. I use this to set my eye primer or my concealer, whichever I use. I just dip it on there, and it's big, so it's less of a fuss, and I just set everything down. An alternative to this brush is the BH Cosmetics number 7 brush. It is just a little bit smaller, but that is what it looks like. And I use these to set my eyeshadow brush down. They work, like, this style of brush works very, very well. Or you could also use the tip of this brush to do the underneath of your eyeball right there. Just get makeup on the top of the brush rather than the flat portion. The next brush, I do not have hooded eyes, so if you have hooded eyes, I don't think that this brush will be best for you, but it is a very large crease brush. So my favorite one is the Morphe 504 brush, and here's what it looks like. I'm just going to get like a regular shader brush so you can see the difference. Like, there is the difference in the brush size. I really like how this one is domed at the top so it can fit great in the crease, and it's big enough that when I circle, like, it covers a good portion. This is my favorite brush. It's so effortless to use. And an alternative to this one, I'm sorry it's from the same brand, but I have not found another brand that makes, like, crease brushes this big, is the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill JH30 number brush. And here's what they look like side to side, and they are very, very similar. The Morphe brush is just a little bit fatter at the top. It doesn't come to a complete point like this brush does. So I do really enjoy these brushes. I use them every single day. I have like 4 of this brush, so I really, really, really strongly suggest you go pick this one up. It is my favorite. The next, so you'd use your first transition color with this brush, the larger brush. Then, to deepen it up, I would definitely go in with a smaller brush to get, like, the detailed, like, outer portion of your eyeball. And my favorite right now is the ColourPop E2 brush, and there's what it looks like. I also have a few alternatives that are very similar. I have the BH Cosmetics brush in the number 6. And the Sonia Kashuk Blending Crease Brush, which these ones are a bit, this one's not as flat, but these two are a bit flatter, so you can press the darker shadows on and just lightly blend them, and they work really well for darker shades or outer corner shaping. So I really do like these for that purpose. Brush, I have to tell you, like, you don't need this brush. You can get buy with just those first two creasing brush, but if you want to be a little bit extra and make sure you have all of your bases covered, you can get, this is the Jaclyn Hill JH40 brush, and this one is just a smaller brush, so if you wanted to do like a larger detail, or if you wanted to just amp a color up, or if you wanted to like fix something, like let's say you were cutting your crease and your concealer went just a little bit too high, you could take this brush and just blend that edge out so it wasn't as harsh of a line, if you know what I mean. And an alternative to this brush would be the BH Cosmetics number 8 brush. So they are both very similar in how small they are and how pointy they are. The Jaclyn Hill one is a bit more loose, and this the BH Cosmetics is a bit more dense. So I do really like these. I feel like this brush is nice to like fix up some of your mistakes, or maybe your wing is a little too crazy and you just want to take a little bit of a cream shade and like soften that edge up. So these brushes would work great for that. My 4th style of brush. My 5th style of brush would be, my favorite one is the Mud Makeup Destiny 810. I got this from my local salon academy, and it's just very nice and small that I can go right underneath my eye here, like do my under my waterline with this brush. And a good alternative would be the Jeffree Star and Morphe number 13 brush. So this one is just a little bit smaller and a little, it's just a little bit smaller and you'd have to work a little bit more. So I like this one just because it's like the perfect size. If I just get product on the very tip and just go on my edge and smudge it out, just great. And I do really like these brushes for that purpose. So my 6th brush that I would recommend is For someone who would want to cut their crease. If you cut your crease, you can use these brushes to both cut your crease and pack product on after you cut your crease. There is the, these are all basically the same. So this is the ColourPop E3 brush. This is the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill 41. So this brush here is the ColourPop E3 brush. And then this one here is the Morphe 41 brush. They are very similar to cut the crease. They work very well. I do really like them. They're just nice for putting on cream product, in my opinion. And then the other brush I would like to recommend is the Jeffree Star number 10 brush. And this one is the bristles are a bit shorter, so that way this one, I would use this one specifically to pack on product, like pack on a eye shade, and it works really well. Plus it has a smaller, so you can get into your inner corner a lot easier rather than making a huge mess. Number 7 is a smudge brush. I really like to do this to either fix mistakes or also go up underneath the eye. So you can either pick this style brush or the mud style brush that I was talking about earlier. But I really like this one more, a little bit more, just because it's flat and I don't have to worry about making a big mess. So if you are a beginner to makeup, I would recommend this one over the other two. But I have both the Eco Beauty Australia brush. It doesn't have a number on it or anything. It doesn't tell me what it is, but that is what it looks like. Just very pointy. And this one is the Sonia Kashuk Smudge brush. So I would use these to smudge product on my underneath line, or if I wanted to have like a very dark color in my crease but in a very targeted location, I would use these. And they're very like goof proof, like they're easy to fix, because if you apply product with these, you can go in with a larger blending brush and kind of like buff it out if you do make a mistake. So these are very, very good for beginners, in my opinion. And my last recommendation brush, so 8 complete brushes for your eyeballs, would be an inner corner highlight brush. I have both the Morphe Jaclyn Hill 42 brush and the Luxie 246 Precision Crease Brush, which they both look very similar. This one here is a Luxie brush, and this one here is the Morphe brush. Honestly, the Morphe one is my favorite just because it is a bit smaller. But they work great to apply product to your inner corner and your brow bone up here. But honestly, I prefer this brush right here, which is the Luxie 209 Large Shader Brush, to apply product to my brow bone, because when you apply it to your brow bone, it's just the right shape and the right, like, width that you can get your brow bone and not mess up like your shading from your previous shadows. So this is a extra brush. I don't have a, like, something similar to it, so just this guy. So those were all of the eyeshadow brushes that I think deserve a spot in a starter kit. Like, if I were to make a brush kit, would include like these style of brushes. Like, if I ever did create brushes, like if I ever created makeup, I'd want to create brushes, honestly. So these are my recommendations for a starter brush kit. Now I would like to move on to complexion, and then after I do my complexion, I would like to move on to brush and bronzer and stuff like that. So I am going to recommend some beauty sponges. So first is the Morphe complexion sponge, which is like an egg shape. It's very, like, it's not wet right now, so it's not very big, and it's really dirty, which is why I haven't been using it. I just cleaned my brushes, now I need to clean my sponges, but this sponge is really, really nice. Also, the Real Techniques sponge is really nice, and the Ulta Beauty sponges are really nice. I really like the Ulta Beauty ones because around holiday time, they come out with this box that has like 20 of them in it for like $15, which, why not? Why not? So I still have a carton of beauty blenders, plus a whole bunch of them are dirty right now. So I really do like these sponges. Honestly, I prefer the Ulta Beauty brand over the Real Technique brand. This one is just a bit softer and a bit easier to use, in just my opinion. The Morphe M444 brush and also the Morphe R6 brush, which is the rose gold cap. This one is, the bristles are a bit shorter and stubby, and it's more dense, which is more for a cream product. This one has larger bristles, and it's more loose. And this one would be for cream products. And I have an alternative to this one, which is a dollar, which is the AOA Studio F27 brush. It just has a small handle, and it's the same. It's got a little bit thicker. It's for cream foundation or liquid foundation. And I do use all three of these. All of the brushes that I will be mentioning today, I do use and I do like. So I do really like these brushes. I mean, like, for cream products, I do use them. I just prefer to use a beauty blender for cream products, because brushes that you use on cream products are very hard to clean. So I don't necessarily love these, but just because I don't like to clean them. But I do like to use them, because sometimes I don't want to use a beauty blender, or if I sat down and start doing my makeup and I don't have a wet beauty blender, I'll just reach for a brush rather than get up and go wet a beauty blender, which is kind of sad, but whatever. And since we're going on the no beauty blender, I want to include some concealer brushes. I have the Morphe M335 brush, which is just like a domed, smaller precision brush. And then I also have the AOA Studio F30 brush, which is a dollar, which is the same thing. This one's still clean, but they are great for getting underneath the eye and blending it out. So if you don't want to use a beauty blender, these are a great option for concealer. Powder foundation, my favorite brush. I got it at TJ Maxx. It is the It Innovation Beauty Brush, and it is huge. Like, I love this brush to just set my face, just because it is so easy and so effortlessly. But I can't find a brush like this at, like, drugstores or anything like that. I've looked and I can't find one, so I do have alternatives if you can't find a big fluffy brush like this. But for powder foundation, this brush is just killer. It's even, like, this top part has even fallen off, and you can see, like, the dents in it. I had to, like, use pliers and squeeze it back on there, because I was not getting rid of this brush. This brush is my favorite. Three alternatives for that brush, which is the first Sonia Kashuk powder brush, which honestly this is, like, my second favorite. It's very large and dense, so it's not as big as that one, but I do really enjoy this brush. And then the ColourPop F1 powder brush, I really do like, and an alternative to that one would be the AOA Studio F26 brush, which is just the same. If you really like this one, and if you're on a budget, these brushes are great. Check out AOA Studios. Some things are hit and miss. I really do like their brow products, and their brushes are really, really nice. Now I'm going to talk about a brush to either apply or sweep away setting powder. I really do like this one, but it is discontinued. This is a Tarte one. So not this specific brush, but a brush just like this. It's like pointy at the middle and like fades out all the way around. And I do really like this because it's really nice to just sweep away like your extra bake. And then there is also this brush, which is very similar. It's just not as loose. And that one's prettier, honestly. This is the BH Cosmetics No. 1 brush. And I do really like this to sweep away, like, bake and things like that. Or, even powder. So, I recommended 4 brushes for complexion. Or not complexion, for complexion and everything like that. And then I also have a few different brushes for bronzer and things like that. First, I'm going to talk about powder bronzer brushes, and then I'm going to talk about cream bronzer brushes, because there is a difference. You do need a different brush to apply each. For powder bronzer, my favorite brush. If I lost this brush, I would immediately go out and buy another one. I love it. It is the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill 02 brush, and here's what it looks like. It is already dirty because I love this brush, and it is my go-to. And it's just, like, flat and just really nice. I really like it because it's not round at all, so you don't have to worry about, like, having your bronzer get too low or too high. So I just keep it, like, keep circling my brush upward, and I do really like this brush. It is my favorite brush to apply bronzer. And then a alternative for that one would be the Real Techniques. This is the number 300 brush, and here is what it looks like. It is the same. This one is just not as dense. It is a bit smaller, but they look side by side. The Morphe brush on the left is a bit more dense and a bit larger than the Real Techniques brush, but this one is a great alternative if you don't want to get this one. Cream bronzer brushes, so you can either apply it with a brush like this, which is the Morphe E46 brush, which is very small and you just very precise. You dip it into your cream and draw it on. Or you could use, which is my personal preference, the ColourPop F4 brush, which is like a small stippled brush. I just dip this in there and dip it where I want it. And then I take a larger brush like this, which is either the BH Cosmetics number 2 brush or the AOA Studio F26 brush. And then after that cream bronzer is applied, I'll take this brush and blend it out. That way I'm not like getting like patchy or anything like that. So it's blended out nice and evenly. It does take two brushes. And personally, I like to use two brushes with cream products just so I don't mess it up, especially for my bronzer. So I would highly suggest applying it with one brush or applying it with your finger and taking another brush to blend it out and buff it out rather than like a looser brush so it's not as harsh on your skin. Let's talk about blush. Those were the three brushes. I had recommended three brushes for bronzer. Now I'm going to also recommend three brushes for blush. So first is the Farrah 50F brush, which this is what it looks like. I got this in an Ipsy, and it is perfect at applying brush. Like, you just smile and it just gets everything you need. It's just, this brush is my ride or die. Like, I love this brush. So Ipsy did a great job in sending this to me. Plus, it's got some really nice detailing on it. And it's just very loose and domed, and like, it distributes product very evenly. The Morphe Jaclyn Hill JH04 brush, or a brush like this, it is kind of staggered, so it's short and then long. Then you could go and go like this with it. I would take this and put it on the apple of your cheek and just pull it backward. I personally prefer a rounder, smaller brush for my blush, but I know a lot of YouTubers like this style brush, and a lot of my friends like this style brush, so I thought it'd be very beneficial to mention it. And then for cream blush, I would use the Sephora. This is the foundation brush, and if you look at it, the front is shorter and it tapers like back, so that way you can either, I would either apply it to the back of your hand and dip your brush into it, or apply just a little drop and then like move it around your blush and then apply it to your cheek, because that way like it just gets everything really, really nice. Bethany from Sephora, I love her. She recommended me to this brush when I bought my Fenty Beauty like blush sticks, and I've really been loving this for my cream blushes, so this brush is staying with me. And then lastly, my highlighting brush. I have two different styles to recommend to you. This one is the Morphe 501 brush, which is just like a longer domed brush, and then it has a very loose, like if you want more of a subtle highlight, this is the brush you want to go with. It distributes the product very nicely and you just swirl it like on the high points of your cheek. Or if you want more like of an intense impact like highlight, I would suggest a brush like this. And this one is the AOA Studio F19 brush, which is also a dollar. And that way you can just apply it where you want it and the pigment is going to stick there. It's going to be very like in your face, very pigmented, and I really do like these style of brushes. So there's the two different highlighting brushes that I think are worth noting. So with everything I've mentioned today, like, you don't need everything, but everything has its own purpose. And I'm not saying you should go out and buy all of these brushes, but find something with a similar shape, with like a similar structure. Go out. Brush sets are like, they're cheaper than buying each individual brush, but oftentimes they give you a whole bunch of brushes that you're not going to use. So I would just think about, if you're going to buy a brush set, look at the shape, look about what you can use it for, like, do I like that style of brush? And what I like to do, if I don't like at least half of them, don't buy it. It's not worth it. It's, most of it's just gonna sit. Or, like, the AOA Studio, those sets are really nice. It's like $12 for 10 brushes, plus you get a little bag. So I really like those brushes. Morphe, BH Cosmetics, Sonia Kashuk's a little bit more expensive. Real Techniques is a little bit more expensive. I try to do kind of like my cheaper brushes rather than my like crazy high-end brushes. I don't have a whole lot of them, but the ones I do have are like, why would you spend that much money if you're, this is a starter kit. You don't need to spend $30 on one brush. Like, cool your jets, one step at a time, walk before you can run, okay? So that would be all of my brushes. If you've made it to this point, thank you for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up. Hit that big red subscribe button if you like makeup content. I am trying to be very consistent and at least post 2 videos a week, and I have been reaching that goal, so I am happy. And remember, as soon as I get to 100 subscribers, I will be posting a video of a giveaway. I have a whole bunch of goodies sitting there behind me. And let your friends know and your family know, and I will see y'all next time. Bye!